doorway work here. So we haven't really had an opportunity yet to go over like truly doorways. Like we did the gate stuff and everything, but we haven't really had like real doorways to do. So we're gonna cover that now with this dog. And I'll show you guys obviously like my process of doing it, why I do it. And in addition to that, why I think like standard ways that people do doorways are essentially incorrect, right? So we'll start with that. So most normal people would typically walk up to a gate. They would tell the dog to sit, right? Then they would open the gate and try to go through it and have the dog maintain the sit. Now the problem with this is you're only communicating to the dog in that situation to sit. You're not saying anything about this gate, it opening, or what specifically we don't want it to do. So what tends to happen? What tends to happen is if you don't ask the dog to sit, the dog will still rush through it. Or the second thing that tends to happen is the dog sit right here. Right? You know, they'll sit, but it'll be like 2 inches away from like where the actual gate is, right? So what I do is I do the opposite approach, right? I will tackle the doorway first, right? So opening that gate like we did yesterday with Riker, making sure that they don't rush through that doorway initially. From there, if I want to put a stationary position into it, like a sit or a down or whatever it may be, I can. But what you're doing is you're actually turning the door opening into the cue to do that, right? So no differently than when we were conditioning in cues with sits or downs or whatever, how that cue needs to come first and predict what happens after. If I'm opening the door, then putting the dog into the sit, opening the door, then putting the dog into the sit, eventually opening the door should become the cue to do that on its own, right? Right now, we're not going to worry about a stationary position because at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter. It's more of like, it looks fancy, right? It's nice to do like when you're just training your dog in general. Right now I care about the arousal of not rushing through the doorway. So most behavioral issues that we have with dogs are a result of, again, the impulse control and trying to engage in the stimulus, right? Dog reactivity. Dog is trying to engage in whatever the stimulus is. Human reactivity, engage in the stimulus. Doorways, this is a stimulus. It opening up, the dog wants to go towards it, towards it, towards it. What I try to condition is the opposite. The dog to either stay still or move away from it. Again, like what we did with her dog, the lab with the reactivity, where we were just correcting for the forward motion. I want to start to condition moving away from those stimulus, right? So what I'm going to do is we're going to do these three doorways. So going through this gate, going into the front of the house, and I'll show you how we're going to go about doing that. Obviously, we're using the pet corrector here for this because this dog can't be on any training tools right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open the door. Now, because I've spent a lot of time working on the general working on the general attention and keeping her essentially staying behind me as I'm walking, she's already starting to pay enough attention to me where this gate opening isn't that big of a deal. Now, like we saw yesterday with Reich, what was that?
Trained that way at the rescue. When we open her gate, she must sit and give us eye contact.
Beautiful. So you guys already have a head start on this, right? What we'll probably see is we'll probably see the front door and the doors actually going into the house are a little bit more difficult because they look different. This is an open gate. She can see through it. She knows what's on the other side. So because of that, you don't get as much of the same effect with it. So she did pretty good with this one. I corrected obviously for her going through there, but she did relatively okay. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to say, okay, walk through and we're going to start walking up to the house here now. All right, same deal with the slider door here. Now naturally, you see this one's creating a little bit more attention. She can't see through it as well, so we'll see what we get. I'm gonna open the door. Now when I'm doing this, another big point is I'm not slowly opening the door, trying to help her with it. I'm opening the door in the speed that I naturally wanna be able to do this with, right? Which is normal. I'm gonna open it. No. Now pull her on out. I see how much more arousal was associated with this doorway as opposed to the other ones. Again, because partially because she can't really see through it as well. And it's a different type of door. She knows this is leading into a house or a building or whatever it may be. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna close the gate for the door. I'm gonna walk away from it and then we'll go ahead and do that again. Same deal, door's opening. Giving her that decision to make a choice. This time she's leaving plenty of clear space here. This is the other cool thing about doing it this way as opposed to like a sit or whatever, is once they realize that this is the criteria, they tend to give themselves more space and you more space. So you're not crowded at the doorway as much, right? From there, okay, we'll walk in. Then I'm gonna do the same deal at the front door. Is it unlocked? Cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and just open it up. See, she's thinking, no. Then I'll pull her on out, come on. Now you can see that time she thought a little bit more, but it's still that impulse, that compulsive response she has of needing to just charge through it, charge through it. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that one again here. again, leaving a lot more space this time. Taking my time, making sure she's committed to not making that choice. Okay. And then releasing through. Now, can you close this gate? Josh, if you wanna come in with me, and then I'm gonna do them going back out. Now, right here, what we're seeing, I just opened this. She didn't rush through it, but she is kind of trying to pull and sniff over there. Not concerned about that right now. Again, when I'm working on anything new like this, I pick and choose my battles. Right now, the only criteria is the doorways here. So she's waiting. Okay, I'll release her through. Come on. Then I'll do the same deal with this one, opening it, giving me good eye contact there. Okay, and then releasing her through. Come on. All right, so what I'm gonna do is just walk her down here for a minute. I'm gonna turn around and I'm gonna do those one more time. So same deal, walking back up, opening the door, no. Marking with no, giving the spray, come on, getting her back out. I'll turn around, we'll do that again. Notice my timing with this also, my no marker is coming first, and I'm taking my time giving the correction. It could come 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds later. As long as I've marked for what I am correcting for, it doesn't matter. Okay. Same deal here. Much better. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, she gets out like once or twice a day. You can get. Yeah. Over a period of a week, like.
All right, then we're gonna walk her back into the back.